I saw this in Robert Dyas. It's £9.99, and it's a bug zapper. Now, I've had this one from Poundland for ages, you know. Ah! Fuck! It always shocks me how powerful they are. So, I've had this one for a long time from Poundland. God, they really hurt, don't they? Well, anyway, I got this one, and this one's more powerful by the looks of it. Now, let's get into this ridiculous packaging. This heat-sealed plastic nonsense. Now, it says 2-in-1 Buzzkill indoor and outdoor bug zapper. And it says in the bottom, keep those bugs at bay by murdering them. And it's got a picture of a mosquito, a fly, and a wasp in a circle with a line through it. Now, in the summertime, there's already a few bugs that keep coming into the flat every now and again. Not really yet. And it really is annoying. You know, you're just merrily sitting down, then all of a sudden it gets bzzz. Very annoying. So, I'm gonna crack into this and see what we'll get. It says, solar charged by day. No batteries needed! Exclamation mark. Well, of course there's a battery needed. You know, just it's charging itself up. So there's a battery in it. They could have marketed that a bit better, you know. They could have just said rechargeable battery included. So what do you get? Let's have a look. It's quite bulky, actually. I was going to say quite light, but it's quite substantial. There's a solar panel bit on the back. And it doesn't look particularly well made. This bit juts out a bit. Is that going to clip back in? No. And there's a bit of a stress mark on the plastic there. So this the build quality already looks a bit suspicious. I hope Big Clive gets one of these and takes it apart so we can see what's in it and what's not. So right now it's turned off. And I'm going to switch it on. By sliding it. So apparently that's on now, we think, but how do we know? I had to stick something in it to find out, aren't I? Danger! High voltage! Where am I touch? Where am I kiss? So it's one AAA NIMH battery inside. 600 milliamps. Sorry, I've just eaten a burger and I've still got it stuck in my teeth. I hope that's not visible on the camera. Made in PRC, People's Republic of China. Oh! It's got a little blue light that's flashing. Oh, I see. So in the daylight, it stops charging, but as soon as you cover over the solar panel, the blue light comes on. So it works at night, so it'll check the bugs at night. That is a great idea. Oh, I like that. That's great. That's like what you get in factories and restaurants, isn't it? You know, they've got that blue light zapper thing. That's quite good, isn't it, for a tenner? So far, we don't know if it works yet. So, I'm going to leave it sun side up and we'll read the instructions and see if there's anything hilarious in that. And then we'll stick something in it and we'll see if it makes a zap noise. It's got four little suction cup things to stick onto the window or wherever you want to stick it. And I'm just looking for the English side. It's like, Achtung! That's not English. And, that's not English. Where is it? Ah, here we go. Oh no, important antes. That's not English either. What is this? Oh, here we go. GB. Insect solar disc for window. 087306. This device sticks on your window in order to solar charge the integrated battery in the sunlight. It is powered by solar energy. When in on position, at night, the blue LED lights up automatically and deactivates the live wire on the metal, and activates, rather, the live wire on the metal grid. The blue light attracts flying insects, and the live wire kills them. Basic instructions and first use. Set the unit to the on position, by holding it down, by holding the red button, I've already done that, and twisting the cover, because that's what keeps the button pressed down lock. By the square, blah, 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 blah. Stick the unit to the inside of the window where it will receive sunlight during the day. At night time, the blue light will automatically turn on, and the electric wire will become active. Maintenance. Insects must be regularly removed from the device. Yeah, you're going to have a lot of dead carcasses lying around, aren't you? Follow these steps. Twist the front cover until the two arrows near the power button are aligned. This turns off the power. Yeah, so just reversing the way you turn it on. Pull the front cover away from the unit to expose the metal grid. The metal grid is now accessible and can be cleaned with a paintbrush or a soft brush. Ensure that insects are removed in order not to overload the battery. Maintenance should be carried out as often as necessary. Dimensions, specification, blah, 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 blah. Warning! Never, there we go. This is the bit I wanted to get to. Warning! Never touch the metal grid or device with your fingers or any other object. Yeah. The device is for domestic use only, and it is necessary to take the usual precautions. Do not wet the device and keep it away from water and heat. Switch off the device before cleaning it. Important notes, keep out of reach of children. No, give it to your kids. It's a toy! You know what I mean? Oh, that'd be good to like punish your kids with, wouldn't it? You know, like, behave! And just zap them. Do not use in places where presence of flammable vapours or explosive dust is likely. Do not use in barns, stables and similar places. What's the difference between a barn and a stable? Is a stable just a barn without a door? I don't know. If you're religious, ask Jesus. I don't know. Do not use in places, blah, 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 blah. Clean the unit of all insects whenever you feel it is necessary, or at least once per week, without any chemicals or consumables. This device has a lifetime of 2 years. However, you can extend the service life by replacing the internal battery with a new rechargeable battery of 600 milliamp per hour. This must be performed by an experienced handyman. Yeah, because we all have an experienced handyman lying around, don't we? That sounds a bit weird. Why would an experienced handyman be, like, laying around? Surely be sacked. So anyway, we're going to give this a try. And apparently the plastic cover comes off. So, oh, that's it turned off. And now there's a grid, a plastic thing you can take off. This might take a while, so I'm going to pause the video now whilst to figure out how to set this cover off to clean it. Figured out how to do it. There's like two arrows that you got to line up together. So I've... Gosh. There's actually a fly in the room now. So I took off the plastic grid. It comes off particularly easy, really. And then that's the live danger. Dun, dun, dun. Meteor killer flies and wasps and other insects. Moths. This is going to be hilarious. Moths. Oh, yeah, get a big massive mosp. That mosp? Yeah, a mosp came about when a moth got a bit randy with a wasp. And what happened is these mosps flutter around in the dark, stinging people. God, that'd be the worst insect ever. Ever? Why can't I speak today? A mosp? God, oh, my skin's... Oh, a mosp. That'd be the most evil, horrific, nastiest insect, wouldn't it? A wasp that comes out at night and stings you. Ooh. Anyway, moving swiftly on. So when that button's pressed down, that means this is live, doesn't it? God, yeah, that's not very safe, is it? This is just a recall waiting to happen. Now, we need something that's not going to conduct electricity. So, because I want to wear it zap. So, say, look, I'm not feeling anything there. and that gosh, it is a bit sillily dangerous. I may die. So I've pressed the button. I think it needs to charge up a bit. Yeah. That's very disappointing. Yeah, I was expecting a big anyway, so this is going to have to be like part one, isn't it? And I'll have to let you know if it's any good or not. So I just got to wait for a fly to fly into it now. Anyway, thanks for watching part one. And we'll see if this is actually any good. Or just a waste of 10 British pounds sterling. Ugh. Did I have the button pressed down? Let me just double check. Let's take this lid off again. So I've pressed the button down. Yeah, I did, because the light came on. And it's not zapping. Should I put my tongue on it? No, I won't do that. Right. Yeah. Keep an eye out for part two. And we'll see if this is any good or not. Thanks for watching. Please scratch and I'll see you when I see you. Bye.
Not very discreet sucker to the window, is it?